Picture this. You're staring at a whiteboard with stick figures, ovals, and lines. The whole thing looks like it was drawn by a five-year-old.
Is this an ancient cave drawing? Should I fetch the archaeologists?
It's a use case diagram.
Ah, so confusion is intentional.
Your project manager just asked you to make sense of the requirements using a use case diagram. And honestly, you're not entirely sure what you're looking at. Here's the thing most developers won't tell you. They're doing use case diagrams wrong, and it's costing them weeks of development time.
And dignity. Don't forget the dignity lost pretending to understand arrows labeled extend.
I've seen use case diagrams that look clean, but tell you absolutely nothing about what the system needs to do. It's like having a map that shows roads, but not where they go.
And then getting blamed for driving in circles.
Which brings us to why this matters. Use case diagrams done right can prevent scope creep, reduce feature bloat, and actually get everyone aligned.
Alignment, that mythical event that occurs 5 minutes before launch panic.
Still better than alignment happening after you ship. Most people think use case diagrams are just fancy flowchart. They're not. They're behavioral models focused on user goals.
Wait, humans have goals? I thought they just click buttons until dopamine hit.
Exactly. A real use case maps to that dopamine. It's about what the user wants to achieve, not what the system does.
So process refund is bad. Get my damn money back is better.
That's not terrible, except the wording. Let's break it down. Actors, not specific users, but roles like customer or admin. Use cases, clear goals like complete purchase or track order. Relationships, associations, includes and extends that reveal complexity.
Yes, the visual spaghetti that unlocks the real conversation.
Yes, because the diagram isn't the deliverable, the discussion is. I once had a product owner ask, what if someone wants to split payments between two credit cards? That one question led to 2 weeks of requirements we would have missed completely.
And six extra test cases, which the intern will now write poorly.
In your code base, these diagrams guide your service layer architecture. Each use case maps to coordinated business logic, clear boundaries, better tests, cleaner code.
So you're saying diagrams equal modularity.
Exactly.
And meetings equal existential dread.
Also correct. But this kind of meeting actually saves you pain later. Now here's the truth. Your diagrams will evolve. The point isn't perfection. It's clarity. Enough to start with room to adapt. So next time you're staring at ovals and arrows, remember, they're not just drawing pictures. You're aligning teams on delivering actual value. The real question isn't whether to use case diagrams.
It's whether your team is emotionally ready to talk about checking edge cases without weeping.
No, the question is whether you can afford not to understand what your users want.
Yes. User goals, the same ones that change 3 times per sprint.
And that's why diagrams evolve. Stay with me.
I am staying. I'm the co-host now. Say it.
You're on screen. That's it.
Fine. But if they don't subscribe, I'm deleting their CI pipeline.
Drop a comment. Tell me about your weirdest use case, or that one diagram that saved the project from certain death. And hit that subscribe button. We're diving deep into the tools that turn good developers into great ones.
And also teaching you how to survive meetings without crying blood. We'll see you next week, if they let you host again.